天晚上的课总共有两大部分，嗯、有一部分就是说，赛前准备活动，
嗯，
跟赛后的放松。
赛前准备活动，赛后放松。
对。
Today is divided into two parts. The first part is warm up before the matches, and the second part is the stretches after the matches.
第二个部分就是说速度素质的训练。
Session one is the training of speed.
然后现在先说啊，先说的是准备活动。
Now this part is warm up.
主要说准备活动对于运动员跟对于教练员的话，有三个部分。
For warm up, players should pay attention to three parts.
第一个是预热。
First is pre warm up.
第二个是一般准备活动。
The second is general warm up.
第三个是这种专项准备活动。
The third one is specific warm up.
就是说这三个部分它是循序渐进的。
These three steps, you should go the first, then the second, then the third one.
就是说从最简单到最后的专项准备活动的话，他们可能要接近于比赛强度。
From the first, pre-warm up is the easier one, and to the last part, the specific warm up, which is close to the match strength.
对，就是说。可能有一帮小的，他们有来训练八天，他们也都知道说，我带准备活动的时候，刚开始会进行一个全身性的拉伸。
From beginning, we will have a stretches for the whole body.
对，就是说全身性的拉伸，你就是跟他们说举个例子，举个例子，你比如说往上的拉伸，对不对？还有左右旋转的拉伸，还有往下的拉伸，这个就是一个全身性的一个预热。
As you can see, this is a whole body warm up.
就是说，可以给他们举个例子，说在做这种跑动之前，就是一定要说身体要做一个预热。
You know, before running, you have to do some pre warm up, or you maybe get injured sometimes.
对，就说我有给他们带过几次这种准备活动，我都会先让他们说，比如说坐着拉伸，或者说是躺着拉伸，或者说是站着拉伸，就是这些都是属于预热里面的。
Sometimes we will lie to stretch, sometimes we will sit, sometimes we will stand, but these are all pre-warm up.
这些是第一部分。说我现在可以举一个简单例子，说你往上走十次，对不对？它是对一个全身性的。对，它这个从解剖面来说啊，它有可能
解剖，
没有，你说有上下，有左右的旋转，对，说上，对不对？还有下，左右的旋转，腿，对，还有下，对，你包括膝关节，这些也都是一些多关节的这种预热。
As you can see, do upward.Downward and leftward, rightward. This is a warm up for whole body.
对，这个就是为你，特别是在冬天的时候。冬天的时候，因为说小孩子他们现在身体还感觉不到。你如果到了成年人，说15岁以后，你或者说是16岁以后，他们对于身体，这都是很敏感的。
At your age, you can't feel, but in the winter.For some adults, your body is very sensitive to the temperature, so it's very important to do the warm up.
Okay. 现在说的是第二部分。第二部分它就是一般准备活动。
Now is the second part. It's general warm up.
就是一般准备活动，它的目的，它主要是要提高身体的温度。
The point of general warm up is to increase the temperature of your body.
对。就像我带他们跑步
，like circle around running，
别带他们跑步完之后活动关节，就是第一个是要提高身体的温度，第二个是要什么？增加身体关节的活动度。
The second point of general warm up is to improve agility of your body, of the joint, of every part of body.
就是说，通过。怎么样才能提高身体的温度呢？就是一定要动起来。
how to increase the temperature of your body just to move.
对，你可以从上到下，你也可以从下到上。
You can from upward to downward. Also, you can from downward to upward.
对，像在跑步的时候，你跑个两圈预热完之后，你就可以做一些，你就可以做一些增加关节活动度的动作，像肩关节前后的绕环，对不对？整个肩关节前后的一个延展性，上下的一个延展性，对不对？你包括到后面的腿的，你必须通过不同多方位的这种运动去提高你这种身体的温度。
After running, you increase the temperature of your whole body, and later you can do some circle around your shoulders. It will improve the flexibility of the joint of every part.
Yep. Okay.
你要不做一些。
对 ，OK， 就是说一般准备活动的话，像比如说一般准备活动，你可以跑完之后，比如说跑动起来，全身动起来完之后，全身动起来完之后，你可以做一些关节活动度的东西。
When you are running, you can also do some shoulder circle.
不同部位的，说尽量做一些有你不要单单做一些。直面的，
要做直面。
对你还要做一些步伐，就是不同角度。
When you do this, do shoulders, do circle your shoulders, not only forward, but you also need to do some leftward or rightward.
Yeah. You can know, don't straight and here, no, any corner. Yep, back, you go back.
Do it in different angle.
这点要记住，提高身体温度跟提高关节的活动度，一定要记住。
These are very important points you should remember.
Yeah, 有这个完之后，身体提高你身体温度之后，你再进行一些拉伸，会更好。
It will be better for you to stretch after the general warm up.
对，然后说提高完之后，你再可以做一些，特别是针对乒乓球的，肩关节、髋关节跟膝关节的。的一些特定拉伸。
So we will do some specific warm up, which is related to table tennis, like your shoulders, your waist, and your knees.
Yeah. 就是还可以根据一些说的拉伸啊，就一般的拉伸，说像是一般的拉伸完之后，说这种是你一定要采用的是动态拉伸。
Like this normal stretch up, it must be dynamic.
特别说我要介绍一种方法，对于他们这种韧带很不好的人，这种关节活动度很不好的人。
The method Ms. Zheng will show, the target player is those, whose joint is not very good.
Yeah. 就是说我可以举个例子。这种方法叫对抗拉伸法。
This method is called competition, stretches.
Yeah, competition. 像先，我先举个例子，你脚一只脚抬起来，就你勾脚尖抬到你所 OK， 说他现在他所能抬的就到这。
Try to reach the highest。
抬后，抬到最高的时候，我这边用肩膀帮他顶住，他发力，他腿发力，他跟我的肩膀形成对抗。
When he reaches height, another people will use some strength to against this feet.
对
and you also
别
and you also use some strength to against his shoulder.
好，这一 OK. And one more times. OK. 踩了发力，对，稍微发起身力，对，好，对。就是这种拉伸法，你再让他腿抬一下，抬高。
And the first time, the highest point is here, but the second time, he can reach here.
Yep. And 你可以从另外一只脚，你也可以试试，对。
And you can try another feet.
对，我试完之后，90度，他可以。
Both of them will use strength at the same time.
现在他的整个关节活动度，他就已经有延展性。
the flexibility of this his joint is very good now.
这个适合身体的所有关节。
This shoots to every joint of your body.
就是你包括你的肩关节。
Include shoulder joints.
对，你的髋关节。
And the waist.
对，
yeah.
跟你的膝关节都可以用。
And knee joints.
对，做完拉伸完之后，你必须要做一些专项的准备活动。
After these warm ups, you will do some warm ups related to table tennis.
对，像一些专项准备活动的话。你包括腰。
This warm up improves the warm up to the waist.
说腰，你一定要用你最快的速度。专项准备活动的话，它一是激活神经。
You need to be the fastest, and the first point of this is to activate the neural.
对，说像神经跟速度训练的话，就是每天都可以练。你只要有练，它就有差别。
The training of speed and neural, you can do it every day.
Yeah, 就是说你有没有去适应它，这种是很关键的。
Come here.
说他这个啊，说就做一次，啪，重，对。
Do the quick steps forward and backward.
像这种是速度训练完之后，他如果说是多次的去重复的话，他会变得越来越快。就这种是一种神经提高。
When you repeat this practice, again and again, your speed will be faster and faster.
对，这样你才能接近比赛强度。
Only in this way, we'll get used to the strength in the competition.
对，像这种小碎步啊，像这种颠步啊，对，它能说是能让你的身体反应更快。
The practice like this, quick steps, will improve the reaction ability, of your body.
对，所以说最基本的，就是有这几种训练。
These methods I just introduced are very basic methods.
但就是我是希望啊，他们以后如果有比赛的话，他们
in the future when you have competitions, it's better for you to prepare a ball and some bands like this.
进行一些拉伸，像。
Like this one is the stretches for your legs and for your hands.
对，因为它有阻抗性，就是跟我刚才讲的那个，它是有那个是有相同的用法。
This one is just like reach your feet highest is the same effect to this one.
对，但就是说还有一点就是他们在比赛之前啊。他们一定要激活他们的小肌肉群。
Before the matches, you have to activate your small muscle.
对，就说小肌肉群的话，它有什么？它有肩关节，有髋关节，跟它的膝关节。
Small muscles includes the part in your shoulders, in your waist, and in your knees.
对，像肩关节的激活，他们可以做收缩肩关节的激活。
As for the shoulders, you can do some practice like this.
对，他们也可以做我平常我给他们做的这种肩关节的肌肉。
And also this is also for shoulders.
对，还有一种是这种小弹力带的激活。说小弹力带的这种侧向激活。
And you can also do something like this.
对 ，Do you understand?Yep, OK, 重激活小肌肉群，使让他们说参与的肌肉越多，他们受伤的概率，他们就会越低。
The target to activate your small muscles is to involve more muscles to participate in your performance, of daily competitions.
对，接下来是一种是臀部的激活。
In this part is about the hip.
对。就是臀部激活，我带他们在练臀部活动的时候，你比如说像这种激活，对不对？都是为了腿的后侧肌群跟臀部肌肉的激活。
In this part, this practice will improve the small muscles, in the hip and the part after the hip.
对。你或者说你可以用这些小的这一种迷你带，对不对？小的这种迷你带来 它的激活你后侧臀部。
And you can also use the small band like this to have the same effect.
对，但就是激活臀部的肌肉啊，就是可以让你在比赛跟训练当中，让你膝关节压力减少。
To activate small muscles in hip and this part, will lessen the burdens of your knees.
对，像这个，这个运动员。
Like her, I think she has a very big problem on her knees.
对，就是说她把全身重心的移动的力量，全部让膝关节承担了。
Because I think when she play, she put the strength of whole body on her knees.
Yeah. 她不懂得用她臀部跟大腿的力量。
She doesn't know how to use the strength from his hips and this part.
对。Do you understand? Yeah. 就是说你们一定要学会如何去分担，把膝关节受力都给分散掉，膝关节它就不会再产生受。
One very important point, you have to lessen the burdens on your knees.
Yeah, 对，说那个赛前的准备活动就是有这么一个流程，看他们都明白了吗？
These are all the parts for warm up.